Need a ride, friend? Whatever you say.
Yeah! Let's go!
Excuse me, miss. Something wrong?
Does it look like something's wrong?
Well, you look kind of upset about something.
Perhaps you don't understand what it's like to be disgraced as a woman. To have people gossip about you and turn from you in disgust day after day.
People can be real unkind, that's for sure.
Yeah. I'm Clara. I used to be a nanny for a family here in Blackwater. The father, he was always so charming. And I, fool that I was, fell for him. Mrs. Thornton, his wife, kicked me out on the street as soon as I started showing. Mr. Thornton turned to drink. Not even a farewell. For a dollar. I have nothing. They will surely take my baby from me. Perhaps you could find the dissolute bastard. Get even a few dollars for me and my baby to find a home. I would be so grateful, sir.
I'll see what I can do.
Something
of mine. The button. Excuse me. You know a girl named Clara?
What's that? Is she one of the waitresses around here?
No, she was a servant at your house.
The only servant we had was that wee darky girl, Sarah. She left to join our people up north.
No, she helped raise your children. You and her had an intimacy of sorts.
Look here, laddie. I'm not sure what you're accusing me of. I'm just here to enjoy the tables. No to hear aspersions against my character.
I understand you want to keep this quiet. Just give me a few dollars so she can set up a modest household for her and the child.
You, you're mine, laddie, or you're just a common criminal, a nerve, are you? You think you can blackmail me or insult me over this piffle? You, outside, no!
Youth.
Mr. Moss, hello. How you doing?
I hope I find you well.
Don't think you'll be needing this.
Howdy there.
Careful!
How are you?
Why, hello, Mr. Moston.
Hey, Clara.
Hello, mister.
Got you some money.
Oh, you are very kind, very kind. And how's Harold? How's my Harold?
Didn't go so well. I'm afraid he's dead.
Dead?
Unfortunately so.
I must go to his grave.
Afraid I don't know where that is.
Oh, he'll be buried in the cemetery in the family plot. Now hurry, I can make it to his funeral.
Whoa there!
Tesla's carriages just ran over a Chinaman.
What do you want, Marston?
My family. I've done what you asked.
No, you haven't. This is the land of opportunity, and I gave you the opportunity to save your family, and you failed. How could I possibly reward you?
Marston, you're a public menace. We should have had you killed.
I wish you had. But since you didn't, where's my family?
Oh, spare me the noble savage falling a sore tripe, will you, old boy? It's nauseating. You don't wish to be dead. You're an insignificant creature desperately clinging on to life like the rest of the scum in this town. Yeah, I know it's tough. You like Dutch. He's a charming fellow. He makes sense. He's like one of those nature writers from back east. Only he takes things a tiny little step too far. Rather than just loving the flowers and the animals and the harmony between man and beast, he shoots people in the head for money and disagreeing with them.
He's a goddamn killer.
Now, I'm not a great intellect, but the metaphysical leap from admiring the flower to shooting a man in the head because he doesn't like the flower is a leap too far. So, I know it's easy. You see, me and Archer, we're the bad guys. We enforce the rules. Now, while the rules may not be perfect, they're really not so bad.
Exactly. What's the alternative?
See, I'll tell you what the alternative is. It's not complicated. It's about one man and his gun versus another man. Sure, civilization may be dull, but the alternative, Mr. Marston, is hell.
And the way you enforce this civilization, this freedom for men to like or not like flowers or whatever in God's name you were just talking about, is to kidnap a man's wife and son?
Well, I know there's contradictions. I'm not going to lie to you. Yeah, as I said, I'm not a great intellect. Now, after the debacle with the army and the bank, we have to put Mr. Vanderlyn to rest ourselves. Will you help us?
Do I have any choice?
Now that you mention it, no.
Then what was that pretty speech in aid of?
I don't rightly know, but it sure felt good saying it.
Shall we, Mr. Marston?
Let's go. Keep your finger off that trigger until we get out of Blackwater.
Come quick! Take a look at this thing! Have you seen this? He's got a gun on the back!
And all my born days, I never seen such a thing.
An iron dragon! That's the devil's work if I ever saw. They told me about these! The army's been building them in secret!
Oh my God! Why are you here with that?
This killing machine of yours seems to be turning a few heads.
Our armed forces have no equal. We have made incredible progress the past few years.
Is that what you call
it? This isn't much more than a simple prototype. You should see what they're working on in Virginia. Soon there will be no war we can't win.
The army has made camp a little way outside town. They put word out a large cache of ammunition and food is stored there.
Vanderlyn's gang needs constant supplies, so that should be enough to draw him in.
No mistakes this time. You hear me, Marston?
I thought you were talking to Fordham.
What's the word, Captain?
We spotted one of Dutch's men about an hour ago. I think he took the bait.
Let's get in position then. Have your men ready to run him down if you have to.
Dismiss! Load weapons and get to the sandbag! Move!
Are you ready to finish this, Mr. Marston?
I guess so.
Hold your fire until I give the word. Targets on the horizon! Fire at will!
Christ, that was close!
Take them early!
Let them through the slot!
How many bastards are there?
Take them down! Goddamn savages!
Keep your eyes peeled. There they are! Open fire! This ends now!
Keep it coming, fellas!
Goddamn savages!
Sons of bitches! I've been waiting for this day! If we have to follow them into the woods.
This is insanity! I can hardly hold on!
Just shut up and drive, Fordham! They're hiding behind the rocks! Gun them down!
Hold them off!
Everyone having a fun time!
Kill those bastards! We'll kill every last one of you!
control! It's coming straight out of cavalry!
I thought we were friends! Any more of you?
Well, Mr. Marston, it seems like your mentor, Dutch, no longer looks quite so kindly to his student.
That man is insane.
So it seems.
I think we need to get him before sundown.
As you say, Captain. Otherwise, he'll be gone again.
And what if I say no?
Now, before I shoot you myself, let me just point out the obvious. The one person we have left that can appeal to Mr. Vanderlyn is the last person we know who knows him. Your wife.
That won't be necessary. Mr. Ross, Captain, let's go.
Mount up, men. Let's move out.
Yeah!
I can't believe Vanderlyn has built himself a fortress in the mountains.
He's crazy, but he certainly ain't stupid.
You've already seen that place, right? McDougal told me you went up there with that Indian chap.
I seen it all right. We'll be lucky to last 5 minutes with this many men.
Governor Johns is gonna be very pleased.
Nate Johns? What's he got to do with any of this?
Let's just say he has a vested interest in cleaning the filth out of this region. I don't think our old friend Dutch realizes what a great favor he has done us, exciting all this hate among the natives.
Like you needed an excuse.
See, this is what happens when you fraternize with savages. How could you ever follow a man like that?
How could you ever follow a man like Ross?
Vanderlyn is a psychopath, a murderer, and a rapist.
Ross don't seem too different. Dutch was a good man once. A far better man than you.
So what made him this way?
I don't know. Bastards like you. Seeing that things never change.
I hope you're ready to finish this mess.
Anything to get you sons of bitches off my back.
There's always somebody watching, Mr. Marston. I thought you'd have gleaned that much by now.
You think you're so clever, don't you?
No, it's you who thought you were clever. You thought you could just walk away from your own life. Make no mistake, we have been watching.
Don't speak to me.
You're really an ungrateful slut, Marston. All we need now is Father Christmas. Instead of punishing you for your crimes, we are giving you a chance to kill the men who betrayed you.
You didn't have to punish my wife, too.
Oh, please. She's hardly innocent.
Don't you talk about her like that!
Oh, I would never talk ill of dear Abby. You call her Abby or Abigail? I prefer Abby. No, I like the woman. A little rough for my taste, but very pleasant.
I can't wait to put a bullet in your head! When will this be over?
It's you who's been dragging it out, not us! We sent you to Fort Mercer with the simple task of killing Bill Williamson. Next thing you know, you're running all over Mexico like a headless chicken.
And now it's Dutch.
But he's the last one of your merry band, is he not? Then you can go back to your farm, or what's left of it. If need be, you can always send your wife back out to work. I hear she works hard.
Go to hell!
This old gang of yours just won't die easily, will it? I wonder how many deaths you are all responsible for. How much money you took from pockets of hard-working citizens?
We did more for the people with the money we took than the damn government ever did.
Good God! This flawed philosophy yours again. If you wish to argue the finer points of ethics, I suggest you learn to read first.
And I suggest you learn how to shoot people in the front, not the back.
So you're the one who's gonna kill him?
Dutch? Yep, that's what they...
You, blow that gate open. Move, soldier. Take two men with us. The rest will stay here and take care of the wounded. They'll plant charges at the gate. You and I'll provide the cover fire. This is it, men. Let's get that gate down. Keep them covered now, Marston. Up top! Cover them!
Any man joining this fight, or am I just killing women?
What are you doing? Shoot them! Man. Ryzen, blow that gate open. Get ready to hold off their fire, Marston. Hold them off! We need time to set the explosives!
What now? What kind of joke criminals are you? Dutch alone!
Looks like it's me and you, John. You should have stayed at home.
I suggest you follow me.
This is the United States Army!
Working for the government, John?
Why?
After all I taught you, I'm ashamed.
I don't have a choice.
There's always a choice. You're just too blind to see.
They got my family.
Your family? Abigail was any man's wife, John. Jack, he's another whore's son, just like you.
Killing for?
You never could see what I could see, John. You were too scared. You never get me to surrender. You better kill me, John.
If that's how it's gotta be.
Well, come and get it, then. Come closer. I got a surprise for you.
There's no more surprises. It ends here. So this is it? Your savage utopia? Up here in the mountains?
You wouldn't understand.
It's all in...
This way, come on!
Working for the government, John, after all I taught you. I'm ashamed.
I don't have a choice.
There's always a choice. You're just too blind to see.
They got my family.
Your family? Abigail was any man's wife, John. And Jack, he's another whore's son, just like you. You're weak. You always were. You never have. Son of a bitch! God damn it! You'll never take me alive, John! It's over, John!
I ain't leaving here without you!
Just like me, John. You can't change who you are.
I ain't like you!
Hello again, John.
Hello, Dutch.
We gotta stop meeting like this.
Sure.
I got a plan, John.
You always got a plan, Dutch.
This is a good one.
I don't doubt it.
We can't always fight nature, John. We can't fight change. Can't fight gravity. We can't fight nothing. My whole life, all I ever did was fight.
Then give up, Dutch.
But I can't give up, neither. I can't fight my own nature. That's a paradox, John. You see?
Then I have to shoot you.
When I'm gone, they'll just find another monster. They have to. Because they have to justify their wages.
That's their business.
Our time has passed, John.
So at the end, you didn't have the guts to shoot.
The man's dead, Ross.
Sure. Can I see your gun? Oh, trust me. It looks better in the report that way.
Where's my family?
Your wife was killed in a prison riot last week. So, I'm only joking, dear boy. They were sent back to that Scrabble ranch of yours in Beecher's Hope. They're quite safe and sound.
They better be.
Thank you, Mr. Marston, for everything. I know this wasn't easy for you, but I have to say, you've done your country proud.
Yeah, exactly. See you around, John. Try to stay out of trouble. Come on, Archer. Let's go find somebody else we can annoy.
Thank you.
That's what I've been after. Come on.
Yeah. Go.